Welcome to my channel. My name is Robin Schindelka, and here I talk about everything related to mindfulness, spirituality, and our way to recovery and a happy life. I'm very grateful that you are here today, and I hope you enjoy this video. Hi guys, welcome to a new video. In the last video, I talked about how I didn't feel like dressing up for my videos anymore. But since today, I'm going to be discussing a wonderful topic with you guys, namely feminine energy and how connecting with our feminine energy through habits can actually enhance our well-being, make us feel better, make us feel more peaceful, and yeah, basically tackle our mental struggles. I thought I'd take the time to dress up for you guys, to do my hair, to do my what you can call makeup. For me, that's just mascara. Anyways, so as I just told you, today I'm going to show you some habits that I try to incorporate in my life daily that really help me connect to my feminine energy. And this is for guys as well. If you're a guy who is watching, don't click away, because feminine energy is both accurate for women as for men. Let me just quickly explain. So in relation to my struggles with, for example, eating disorder or anxiety in the past, I feel like this always had to do something with the fact that I was too caught up in male energy, because male energy is very controlling. It's very rational. It's our mind. It's our ability to control things and to really think. But so if I then apply this to what I experienced with having an eating disorder, or even my existential anxiety, because this in some way is also being too much in your mind, being too much in your thoughts, too much in trying to control things. This actually made me struggle a lot. And so the answer to finding that balance to then exit that mental struggle is to really balance a bit to the other side, balance a bit to the feminine side, to take care of yourself, to get in connection with your emotions, and yeah, to just find kind of small habits that you can do every day that make you more in connection with your body, more in connection with nature, more in connection with yourself, and less obsessed with thoughts and control. If you guys enjoy this video, make sure to like and subscribe, as this helps me out a lot on my YouTube journey. And if you would like to work with me in coaching sessions, you can go to my website. I'll put a link below. And my English ebook is also available for sale. More information is all down in the description, but it's basically about finding peace and happiness within without any help from the outside world. So let me show you the first thing I do every day. I hope you enjoy this video.
Feminine energy is about connecting to your body, as male energy is more connecting to your thoughts, your mind, control, as I mentioned. We can actually place ourselves more in connection with our feminine energy by taking care of our body and by really placing ourselves in our body, by feeling our body. And as you can see in this video, I am hydrating my skin. This is something I do every day. As I have pretty dry skin, this is something that I have been struggling with for a while. But I found this wonderful cream and I just do it every day to give myself the feeling that I am connecting to my body, that I'm treating myself, that I take care of myself and love myself. So after that, I put on some hand cream as well. This smells amazing. It's from Rituals. And these are just small habits that really, as I said, just connect you to your feminine side and treat yourself and take care of yourself. I think it's so important. So just moisturizing my hands, and then after that, something else feminine, but this is something men do as well, of course, is to put on some perfume, to smell nice, to again be in touch with your senses, with your body. And the second thing I do is to actively get in touch with my emotions. When we're too caught up in our masculine energy, we actually don't allow our feelings and allow our emotions, because we're so caught up in the mind and in our thoughts that we suppress emotions, don't take them seriously, and this actually makes them worse afterwards. So sometimes just being somewhere, just sitting on a couch and allowing yourself to feel whatever you're feeling right then at that moment is so healing, is so caring, is so loving for yourself. And even if you're experiencing anxiety or depression or very intense negative emotions, This is also important, but because, as I mentioned before in other videos, by suppressing those emotions, you actually make them worse. So just allow feelings, allow to listen to your feelings, to listen to your emotions, and take them seriously. So another way of getting in touch with your feminine energy, as you can see in this video, is by dancing. This places an immediate connection to your body. You allow yourself to communicate with your body, to listen to your body, to also imply emotions in the way you move. And we allow our sexy sides to come up, because there's no denying that we as humans are sexual beings. And by using the sexuality and using these movements and emotions, you actually get in touch with your feminine side, and this helps a lot with taking care of yourself and just regulating emotions and being happy. It also raises your vibration a lot, so you become more happy and you manifest quicker, so that's another plus side. Don't mind my dance moves, it's been a while since I've gone dancing outside, so that's why I'm maybe acting a little weird. The fourth thing I do is to connect to Mother Nature herself. Go with your barefoot on the grass, I've talked about this a lot. And just go outside, go for a walk, connect to nature. I'm very sorry I didn't get like a proper nature shot. I went on a run this morning, so I was already in nature, but I felt too lazy to actually go to a park or something to film. So I just thought I'd go outside. But as you can see, I'm with my bare feet, just connecting to Mother Nature. Number five is to be still, and I can't really explain it any other way. When we're caught up in masculine energy of rush and ambition and work and working harder and harder and faster and faster, and when we put so much pressure on ourselves, we sometimes need to take time to be still, to just meditate, do nothing, be present, be still, light a candle, just feel and meditate, as I said. Because this really balances out the rush that we've been placed in by Western society or other societies where work is overvalued. Just take time to be still, to take time for yourself, read a book or something. Just do nothing. This is so undervalued because we feel like in our societies, work is valued and doing nothing isn't, but doing nothing, being still, is a major, major part of our mental health. The book I'm, by the way, currently reading is A Return to Love by Marianne Williamson. I'm actually reading this for the second time already. It's one of the best books I ever read, and I highly recommend you read it as well.
And the last but definitely not least thing is to love. Love is the opposite emotion of fear. Love is the opposite emotion of struggle and pain. And so we can fix every emotional struggle by adding love into the equation. And love is very feminine, at least that's what I believe. So just take time in your daily life to really love yourself, to love others, to pay attention to how much love there is in the world, to pay attention how much love there is in just nature and connection between humans and animals, and by actually actively loving, allowing yourself to really feel this emotion, you get in touch with your feminine side more and you automatically heal, because you need love in order to heal. So I want to thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to follow me on Instagram on my new account. I'll also put a link in the description, because every day I post like videos and thought pictures and quotes and stuff like that that can really help you and inspire you, and so that I can get to know you guys as well. So be sure to do that. Also, I repeat, if you want to work with me in one-on-one coaching sessions, you can go to my website and we can chat further there. And then I wish you a very wonderful day, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye!